person crossing illegally within seconds from Mexico into the United States through a hole in the fence, going to the store, mingling with everybody, and he was gone within 10 seconds. That was your reaction time back in 1998.
Today, the U.S. Border Patrol has gone high tech.
You have horse patrol, you have ATVs, you have helicopters.
As well as night vision scopes.
There's quite a few folks right there that'll be coming down here in a second.
Unmanned infrared camera towers. Additional manpower.
We're pushing maybe 50 people through a week through the academy.
And new 40-foot tall fences are all helping the continuing fight against illegal immigration.
You know, once you get away from the border area, from the immediate metro area, you have a lot of vehicle drive-throughs, and that's what this fencing does. It stops vehicles from driving through.
The reason for the new advancements?
The Border Patrol will apprehend, you know, approximately 2,000 people per day.
Sneaking people through the international line is not the only concern for the agency. Last year,
the Border Patrol apprehended over 352,000 pounds of marijuana.
So the question is, are the new advancements in technology and infrastructure helping this problem?
Nogales, Arizona probably had 200 entries attempts a night, went from 200 to 10.
We're getting a better hand over controlling this problem.
Agents say new tools and advanced technology cannot fight the problem of counter-surveillance they continue to see from drug runners and human smugglers.
What they'll do is a lot of times they'll have four guys in their truck and they're going to smuggle dope. And they'll drop the four guys and they'll come up north. As soon as it turns dark, they'll come up north and they'll set up on all these high spots and they'll watch the Border Patrol. It's kind of a surveillance, counter-surveillance thing. We'll watch them, they watch us, and we try to outsmart them, they try to outsmart us.
The 350-mile Arizona-Mexican border continues to be the heaviest illegally traveled corridor into the United States. In the past 10 years, the government has spent nearly $20 billion to ensure agencies are equipped with the best technology. No matter how you look at the issue of illegal immigration, it's unlikely to disappear anytime soon. For now, Border Patrol agents continue guarding a country which holds the key to open a better life for so many people.
Here are some of the first replacements that they started getting. They knew exactly where we were. They could mark an X on a map and put a mortar in your back pocket. Most exclusive organization in the country, except maybe ex-presidents. When I was a child, I lived in a lot of places. Lots of the guys like me, we fished, and when we got old enough, we hunted. Slingshots and then BB guns, and eventually things that shot. We got married on June 18th, which was the same date as we met. I got to meet four or five presidents. Somebody said, how old? And I said, 810, give or take a zero. My name is John D. Bud Hawk, and this is my life.